Hey YouTube, it's Gibby back again, another pickups video, this time for the month of October. And I thought I'd do something a little different this time, and what I'll do is first I'm going to show you all the games I got in trades from, other people, and some of them from like Guzex and stuff, and then after that I'll go into showing all the games that I purchased. And like always, I won't be showing everything, so at the end I'll just do kind of an overview again and let you see everything that I got. And go ahead and get started. I'll show you all the games I got for trade this month. Got in on trades, and most of them are loose, except for disc games and stuff. But start off with, picked up an Atari game. I hadn't got an Atari game in quite some time, and this was, it was Skeet Shoot. I got original Echo the Dolphin. For some reason I couldn't find my copy, so I ended up trading for another one. There's some Super Nintendo games I got on trade, and it was Chester Cheetah, Wheel of Fortune Deluxe, Rise of the Robots, Tom and Jerry, and Samurai Showdown. Also picked up Space Ace for Sega CD. I've got the case and manual and everything upstairs, so it's good to get that back. Game Boy Color and Game Boy Advance games took in on trade was R-Type DX, R-Type 3, and The Revenge of Shinobi. Couple 64 games. I got Space Invaders, Tom and Jerry Fist of Fury, and Transformers Beast Wars. Got quite a few PS1 games this month on trade, and some really good ones that I used to have and glad to get again. One of them was Die Hard Trilogy. Used to love playing this game. Another good one I used to like to play was Men in Black, the series. Picked up Star Wars Episode 1, Rebel Saw 2 Star Wars, Grand Theft Auto 2, got Roswell Conspiracies. This one's still sealed, probably keep it that way. Soul of the Samurai, Pro Pinball Big Race USA, Smurf Racer, Siphon Filter 3, I always loved this series. Hopefully they'll do a PS3 version someday. Pitfall 3D, Beyond the Jungle, Fear Effect, I like the Fear Effect games. Pro Pinball, Fantastic Journey, and Micro Machines V3, I always loved the Micro Machines games as well. Some last gen stuff I got traded for. Got the Virtual Fighter, you got the 3TB, and Tomb Raider Chronicles. Also picked up House of Dead 3. Case is in pretty rough shape, but it's complete. Probably swap out the case. Spy vs. Spy. The Incredibles for GameCube. And Hot Wheels Stunt Track Challenge. Some newer stuff I got on trades. Got Guilty Gear Dust Strikers for DS for the kid. Some PSP games for me. I got Warriors Orochi, Prince of Persia Revelations, and Silent Hill Origins. Also picked up NBA 2K8. And Battle of Bands. Nothing special about those. Alright, that was all the games I traded for. Now I'll show you all the games that I bought this month. I ended up importing a lot of games this month. I got 100 Game Boy and Game Boy Color games from Japan. And I needed 83 of those, and they went in my collection, and that's pretty good haul there to have 83 out of 100 of them for ones I needed. So I'm not gonna show you all those, but they'll be on the overview. You can see there in the box, 83 of them, some good titles in there. I also picked up a loose lot of Famicoms. It was 50 in the box, but fortunately I wasn't so lucky on those. I only picked up three that I needed. And one of them, I'm not even going to try to pronounce it. It's this one here. It's something Biomonster. I don't know. And Hyper Olympic. And Dragon Ninja. So I got plenty more Famicoms to trade, and also 17, I think, or 18 of the import Game Boy games. So if you're looking to trade for any of those, just let me know. Some other stuff I picked up from Goodwill. I got Cruisin' USA and 007 for $2 a piece, 64. I got this at the flea market. It's Space Station Silicon Valley. That was $5. Just really looked like an interesting title. Seen it on the Gibbs 24 channel and her collection, and I thought, started looking it up, and looked like a neat little title to pick up. Let's see, what else? Bought the Smurfs 2, imported that. That was $12. Looked like a really cool platformer. These next two games I got off Amazon. We got Super Bowling for Super NES, was $4. And The Wizard of Oz, it was $5. Picked up this Genesis game for $5 at flea market. It's Bubble and Squeak. And I got Calibri for 32X off of eBay for $14.50. It was one of the last remaining games I'm needing for the 32X US library. I'm still missing four games on that. I've been on this huge Master System kick here lately, ever since with all the Nintendo 25 years and everything. Everybody celebrating all the that kind of puts me in an 8-bit era mood, and since, of course, there isn't any really Nintendo games I can search for anymore, I've got pretty much all of those. I've been really digging into eBay and looking for a lot of Master System games, and I ended up picking up quite a few the last month, and several of them were imports, and then some were from here in the States, but go ahead and show you them. Picked up Scramble Spirits. It was $3.75 loose. Blade Eagle 3D was $2.50. The Flash, I imported this. This was $12, but the Flash is one of the superheroes that I always kind of liked. And this, until recently, I didn't even know this game existed, so it was really neat to pick this up and get a chance to play this game. Also got Star Wars for $5.50. Those were the four loose Master System games I picked up. The rest of these were boxed. Most of them complete. And got Global Gladiators for $1.75. Fire and Forget 2 was $3.25. Marble Madness was $2.50. In case you're wondering how I remember the prices, usually when I get stuff in from eBay, I'll put a little sticker on the back with what I paid for it. That way I can keep up monthly what I'm spending. So that's how. I don't have that good a memory where I can remember every single game what I paid for, so I cheat a little bit and put a little sticker on the back. But yeah, it was $2.50 for that. Spider-Man was $2.50. Putt and Putter was $2.50. Got Ghouls and Ghosts finally for the Master System. And this was about $10 imported. Jurassic Park, $5. Air Rescue, I paid $5 for that. Pac-Mania was $7. And I got Space Gun. This is a game I always wanted to try out. And it was $10. I picked up the Audifonts, which looked really cool. I'd watched a YouTube video a long time ago and always wanted to pick this one up. And I got it for a good deal. I thought it was $7. And then I got the R-Type for the Master System. It was $5. Love R-Type games. I ended up picking up 3 of those this month. And let's see. Picked this up for $7 on eBay. It's Land of the Babes, Duke Nukem. This was a Goodwill buy for $2. Little Mermaid 2. Picked up a few games at a pawn shop. Some PS2s and Saturns. And the Saturn games here were 99 cents a piece. None of them are really, you know, stellar titles or anything, but they were all complete, which was really cool. And the cases were actually in good shape. And for 99 cents, I still, they're games I needed in a collection, so picked them up. Blackfire. Decathlete. Machine Head. And NBA Action 98. And some PS2 games I got at the same pawn shop. Picked up Mega Man X8 for $5. And these 3 games here I got for $3 a piece. Got some Konami Kids Playground games for $3 each, and they're sealed. Got the Toy Pals and Dinosaurs. Thought they were pretty cool. I'd never seen these in the stores or in the wild, so pretty interesting. And then I got the King of Route 66. Not sure what that game's all about. I'd never seen that game either. Some of the newer stuff I picked up. I got Iron Man, $15. Iron Man 2, I mean. PS3. I got Death Smiles for 360 for $15. And I got Cursed Mountain on Amazon for $6.61. It's a limited edition version with steelbook case, so that was pretty cool. I picked up, of course, the Back to the Future trilogy. 25th anniversary edition. Everybody loves Back to the Future, including me. Also picked up a couple of odd finds at the Goodwill when I was there. One of them was a Dream Gear plug and play for $1.50. It has 25 games on it. They're all kind of 8-bit style games. Most of them are vertical or horizontal shooters. A couple of racers and stuff like that. Pretty cool, I thought. And for 25 cents, there was a Famicom light gun. Probably went to one of those Power Joy clone systems or whatever. And I tried it and it works. Also found a Tandy portable drive too, it's called. 55 cents and it's like brand new shape. So I'll probably be trading that off or selling on eBay or something. And I just thought it's a pretty good deal. It had to be a good deal for 55 cents. Put the batteries in, it works fine. It runs on batteries or power adapter. If anybody's got a Tandy and need looking for a drive, wants to trade for something, let me know. And finally, sister brought by a couple things she picked up at the flea market and gave me. She found an old Wario, pretty big size plush, and from 2003. She also found a Petey Piranha, so that was pretty cool. Put them up in my game room. Hope you enjoyed this month's pickups. We'll see you next month.